So, welcome to the fifth webinar on advanced JSX graph programming. And I have prepared a few topics which I hope you find interesting. Mainly one new feature of the latest version 1.22. And then I will tell you something about some lesser known elements. And we'll show you something about the power of the turtle graphics. Okay, let's start. Yesterday we released version 1.22, and we got feedback that the new clipping algorithm has its weak points. And in this new release, we tried to fix it a little bit. Especially Matti Hurjala gave very valuable feedback. So let's start with this example. And I want to show you what's now possible. So here we have 3 points. And the circle, and one of these points lives on the circle as a glider, like this. That's okay. So, yeah. And then we create a sector element through these, defined through these points. Visible equal to false, let's say true. Okay, the sector element. And then we create an additional circle with a smaller radius. All the visible true, like this. And then we create the difference of these two curves, the sector and the circle. So again, as I said last month, we create an empty curve with a fill color blue in this case, and we apply this clipping with the difference method. And then it should look like this. Yes, and then we have to call once more update. So it looks like this. So we have now this partial ring or this stripes and you see now the construction. So we can make the circle and the sector disappear again. False, and we don't need this circle, and we don't need to see this point, and we don't want to see this point B. Yes, like this. And additionally, we can, so we have now some sort of gauge, like in a car or something like that, speedometer, like this. And we can output some text, the value of this angle, maybe scale from 0 to 100. And it's like this, okay? And I'm expecting that these kinds of element will be find a good use in further demonstrations. Okay, this is the first example with the new better clipping algorithm. this is just a hint what's now possible. We can now intersected polygons, which can be now quite, or paths, which can be now quite complicated. For example, look at these two circles again. We can also compute the difference. It's the, this ring between the two circles. And then we can take a some polynomial like this. And now intersect the polynomial with this ring. And what you might see is that this curve defining this ring, it has a hole in it, one hole. So it starts to getting complicated for clipping algorithms. And yeah, but now we can intersect the polygon with the ring. And it should work now. Okay. Yeah. Okay. This is the improvement of the clipping is the most notable change in the new version. I must admit, not all extremal cases are already solved with clipping, but I hope that in the next version we will be even better. What I forgot to say last time, and it was indeed asked in the chat. Is can we have the source code of these examples? So I want to show you again especially for those who are new. If you go to the homepage of JSX Graph and go to docs documentation, then you find something about this webinar. And for each webinar, you find this PDF document, which you see here. And there is the source code with the link to this JSFiddle where you can copy the source code. And for today's webinar, I have to update. Yes, the source code is, the PDF is already available. Maybe I will make a few changes afterwards. Okay, clipping. Now let's have a look at some lesser known examples. The first example I want to show you is a segment with a fixed length. You know segments, we have two points, A and B in this case. And you can drag the points or you can drag the segment. And now you can define further two points, C and D. And a further segment, L2. And we supply as a third parameter the number 2, which has the effect that this segment CD has now, from now on, length 2. So if you drag a D, the point C follows. Okay. This might be useful for some constructions. And this number can also be dynamic, which means that we define two more points, E and F. Now you see in this example, in line 20, the segment L3, it has as third parameter a function returning the length of the first segment L1. So, okay, this is F, behaves the same, but if I change the length of the first segment, the third segment changes. Okay, this might be useful in certain contexts. Of course, it's only use. You can now have constructions which don't work, which cannot, where not all restrictions can be fulfilled, and then something happens which can be predicted at the moment. Okay. The next element which I want to show you are angles with fixed values. So let's go to the next example. Okay, so we have 3 points. Yeah, A, B, and C. And two lines through A and B and A and C. And you see they span a rectangular angle. And yeah, okay. And of course, everything is free. I can change these points however I want to. So now we set a fixed value to this angle gamma. And it looks like this. So I just restarted the program. The angle was set to the original value, and then it was set to pi third to 60 degrees. And then the board was updated. So it's now fixed, and I cannot drag this point C any longer. It's a fixed point. I can drag B, and of course I can drag A. But the value is, the angle is now fixed to some, to 60 degrees. Okay, this is the first step. The next step is we can free the angle again by clicking on this button. Then everything is free again. And then we can fix it again. How is this done? Simply by calling free. The angle is simply done by calling a.free. And fixing it again is, I have to call again set angle, of course, with some value and update the board. Okay. Yeah, this is the first step. We can do more with it, make it more flexible. This is the same construction, but we have an additional slider. Yeah. And we can, as usual in JSXGraph, we can bind the value of the slider to this angle, or we can fix the angle to be the slider value. By calling set angle and giving a function as parameter. So the value of the slider, it returns the value of the slider. Then it looks like this, and we can control the angle by this slider. Good. So this is a dynamic value in the script. Then the next element is, it's funny to use it, it makes fun to use it. It's what we call magnetized points. So look at this example. We have three blue elements. Three blue elements. They are all three, and I have a red point B, and nothing is special at the moment. So now I can define attractors, attracting elements. I give it as parameters, as attributes. So, okay, as I'm defining here, I'm giving an array, the line, the circle, and this point, P0, they are defined as attractors to this point P. And I define the attractor distance to be 0.2 and the snatch distance as 2. So what happens now? Okay, if I drag B close to the line, then it snaps to the line, and it's now a glider, a gliding element, gliding object on this line. I can snatch it away by a fast dragging operation, then it's a free point again. You probably assume now, okay, if I do the same close to the blue point, it will have the same will happen. Indeed, it's fixed now to the point. It's a gliding element on this point A. I can snatch it away, and I can do the same with the circle. Okay. And yeah, this might be useful for quite a few situations. Snatch distance means the drag, the next, if the drag event is more than 2 units away from the position of B, then it is set free from this element. And usually this is supplied in user coordinates, but you see in the documentation, the API documentation, you see you can also give it as pixels to if you need a pixel distance for the attractor and snatch distance. Okay. So these are attractor magnetized points, and you can do this for many points and many to make all points be attractors can be done by setting the attribute snap to points. Let's look at this example. We have four segments. First, I want to change these the attributes for these four segments a little bit, though they look they have points. To see the first and the defining points like this. Okay. And then I define the attributes snap to points to true for all points of the construction, and set the same distance to attractor distance 0.5 to attractor distance and snatch distance. Okay, what happens now? Now I can to rerun. So now I can connect this segment to give something to, for example, to give a graph or something whatever I want to. Okay. This is one possible application. Another application is if you want to highlight certain configurations. Good. Okay, these are the elements I wanted to show you, which are not very well known in the JSXGraph community. Now in the second part, or in the last part of today's workshop, I want to recall turtle graphics, or to show you the power of turtle graphics. In the Wikipedia entry for turtle graphics gives you this description: in computer graphics, turtle graphics are vector graphics using a relative cursor, a turtle, upon a Cartesian plane. Turtle graphics is a key feature of the Logo programming language. So Logo was very prominent in school in the 1980s, and there are probably more or less the 1980s. But it's turtle graphics is more than just Logo programming. Actually, the PostScript programming graphics language, or picture language, or SVG, the vector graphics format, actually they are also many ways they can be regarded as turtle graphics. And we have turtle graphics in JSXGraph since the beginning, virtually since the beginning. And turtles are very efficient graphic elements because they are realized directly as SVG path elements, so there's not much overhead. So let's start with an easy example. So we start with a element T, which is a turtle. Okay, we can take out any parameter, then it will look like this. And the parameter, the first are as follows. The first parameter is the x, the position, the x coordinate, and the second is the y coordinate of the starting position. And then there's the angle that in degrees in which the turtle looks at the beginning. So let's give 60. Okay, then it looks like this. So we have now an arrow starting at 10:10 and looking in a certain direction, 60 degrees. But and of course you can set here some attributes of the path which will be developed. So now we can call the method forward of this turtle. And you see I have a quite large bounding box, 50 in each direction. So we proceed 10 units in the direction in which the turtle is looking. Then we can turn around the turtle by 30 degrees. So all angles for the turtle are considered as degrees. So now we can turn it around, and then we can forward again. Then we can set the position to a completely different value. Like this, minus 10, 10. So this arrow is mostly interesting if you play this turtle game, but for serious graphics, it's probably better to hide it. And then, yeah, we can do some loop. So we do 10 times forward 5 units, and then do a right turn by 36 degree, and it looks like this. Then we can go to a different location, like this. If you don't want to have this this line from our ring to the actual position, we have to lift up our pen. And it looks like this. And we set down the pen after the moving. So pen up, move to, and pen down is more or less the same as set position. Then we can change the pen color, and we can change the size. And we can look into a different direction. This looking is also interesting. Let's have a, yeah. We can provide an angle in which direction the turtle should look, or we can provide a point to which the turtle should look. And then we can do a forward move again to be closer to this logo programming language. There are abbreviations for this forward, for most commands. The forward is abbreviated by FD and so on. So it looks like this. Yeah, so we jumped to 2030 to this point, and we are looking to 10-0, like this. And we can do a left turn, and these commands can be changed by connecting the commands with points. So yeah, I just copy this whole command. Like this. Maybe let's have a left 90. This was somehow skipped. And it looks like this. And we can set attribute to fill color. This may look weird, it depends on the context. Then all the paths are filled and it looks like this. Okay, these are the turtle commands which we have available. What do we have? We have forward and its abbreviation, back, right, left, pen up, pen down, clear screen, clean, set position, home, then it goes back to its starting point. Hide turtle, if you don't want to show this arrow, or show turtle, pen size, pen color, attributes, the usual set attribute. And then we can push the turtle on a stack and pop it back. And we have this look to command and move to. And we can get the position by calling t dot x and t dot y. So these commands are more or less copied from this Logo programming language. So SVG and PostScript, they have different commands, but mainly they have move to and line to and so on. So what can we do with it? Here's a more useful example. So we have here one turtle. We define a function graph, function sine. And now we define a start and an end point, -4 to 4. X is set to the start, step is 0.2. And then we create a circle, a turtle at the X on the function graph at point -4. So then we hide the turtle. Okay, and then we do a slow drawing of this function graph. So let's have a look. It looks like this. It's an equidistant plotting of this function, an animated plotting of this function. And it's just, we just keep this position X of the plotting point and move the turtle from the last point to the next plotting point, to the X and F of X. And if X is larger than end, then we stop. And we do this once each 200 milliseconds. Okay, this is one way to show, to do some, or further way to do an animation of graphics. And I set the turtle attribute fixed to false, so as any curve you can, we can drag it away. So, yeah, this is one possible application. Then the next typical application, which has been done in Logo many times, is fractals. This is a strong point of Logo or Turtle programming. Let's look at this construction. So we define, first we define, second we define a function called snowflake. Okay, it has, it needs as parameter some size and a level. And it calls three times the function edge and turns the turtle right by 120 degrees. So if we start here at the beginning, set position 0 and -100, so we are here, and we turn right by 120 degrees. Is it like this? Turn right by hand, yeah. No, let's do 90. Ah, we start in this direction and turn right 90. Yeah, okay. Yeah, we have, yes, here we are left 30, so we are looking Tum. In direction 150 degrees. So, okay, let's do 120 again. So, and edge, what does this function edge do? Well, it seems to draw an edge, but it only does this if the level, the parameter level is equal to zero. Otherwise, it recursively calls itself and does something else. And I want to show it to you. Let's increase the level to one, from zero to one. Then it looks like this. It turns left by 60 degrees, goes forward, turns right by 120 degrees, and turns left by 60 degrees. So, and the edge length is decreased by a factor 3. And if you do this the same again for level 2, it looks like this. And level 3, it looks like this. And level 4, it looks like this. So this is in the 80s and 1980s and 1990s, many such fractals have been drawn with logo and turtle programming and turtle graphics. So in our JSX wiki there, you see plenty of fractals. Okay, and then finally, I want to go a little bit more deeply into mathematics and want to visualize the following problem with turtle graphics. So let's assume there's a population Y, which consists in the beginning at time zero naught of S individuals or units or whatever. And this population grows in each time span delta t by a factor alpha of its actual size. So what does this mean? We have this formula. It grows by, though there's a delta y, it has in each time span delta t, it grows by a factor alpha of its actual size. So if you bring this delta t to the left, you get delta y divided by delta t equals alpha y. And now let's we compute the limit, or we go to the limit, and the time span gets infinitely small. Then we arrive at the derivative dy over dt equals alpha y. So what we want now is what we are searching for is alpha. We don't know why, but we know that y fulfills this equation. The derivative of y equals alpha y. This is called a differential equation. And in this special case, there's a solution. This y, this function y looks like this. You can just have to derive it and check. This can be visualized as, without knowing this, differential equation can be approximated very easily with turtle graphics. So let's look at this specific example. You have S unit in the beginning, there are no 0.1 units. Alpha is set to 0.3, and our time span is 0.1 units, time units. Okay, and then I already computed the correct solution, which has been computed analytically. Yeah. So now we do the same with our turtle. So the turtle, it's is at the beginning in time zero at S. We don't see it, it's here. Then we set the pen size. Okay, we set again the position. This would not be necessary. Okay. Now we define the following function, which we call as long as the turtle has not reached time 20. So we compute. We read the position, the y position of the turtle, the y value of the turtle, multiply it with alpha and the time span. So it's exactly what's here. This gives us the increase in the population, the dy. And then we move the turtle, we move it actually by from the old position to dt and dy. Yeah, that's it. And if the turtle position, the x position of turtle is not, as long as it is not larger than on has not reached 20, we do it again. And then it looks like this. It's an approximation of the exact solution. To be precise, it's an Euler. It's the Euler method to do this, and it's a good approximation. Of course, there are more difficult differential equations where the time span, the steps have to be much smaller. Otherwise, you get lost. In the wiki, there's a more. There's an example about a pandemic. And this is also done by, let's say here we have three equations. We have three, in this epidemic model, the population is divided into three groups. Namely, the first group is the proportion of the population which is suspectable to the flu or to the disease. The second part of the population is they are ill or they are infectious. They can disseminate the disease. And the third part of the population, they are not they are no longer susceptible to the disease because they are immune or outside of the population or whatever. And they are connected somehow by these relations. And this can be simulated easily with these simple calculations by three turtles. And then it looks like this. The three turtles run simultaneously and approximate the correct solution of this differential equations. Yeah. If you want to know more about turtle geometry, turtle graphics, then I recommend this book by Arvidsson and Di Sessa, Turtle Geometry, the Computer as a Medium for Exploring Mathematics. There are a lot of ideas which can be visualized easily with turtle graphics. Okay, and we have many more examples on our wiki with turtle graphics. For example, I didn't tell anything about Lindenmeyer systems, which is also a very nice topic and a fascinating topic. We have two upcoming events. The next webinar will be at the end of April, April 28th, Wednesday at 4 p.m. CEST, Central European Summertime. And we will organize the second International JSX Club Conference. And the date will be October 5th to October 7th. There's no homepage yet, but this will be set up in the next few weeks, and I will notify you over, via Google Groups and other channels. So thank you very much. I hope you got some inspiration, and yeah, please, questions, please tell, please give me your questions or your suggestions what to do next. Okay, if not, then we will see, hopefully we see next time, and enjoy.